Beanblossom's the name. Robert S. Beanblossom. That's me there with a rope around my chest. The pretty girl with the hands tied behind her back is Julie Marshall. Mr. Thackeray, our boss at the Thackeray Realty Company, the red-faced gentleman with a gag in his mouth. Our predicament may seem unusual, but we got into it in the most logical way you can imagine. It's what can happen if you overdo the old saying that honesty is the best policy. It all started this morning in front of the office. You see, we have an entire estate to dispose of. The Thornton estate, consisting of several houses, a bowling alley, three lots, and a cabin cruiser. I'd decided to handle the cabin cruiser personally. How do you like it?
Well, it's very striking. The only thing is, how do you think Mr. Thackeray's going to take it?
Oh, I don't know. He's a little old-fashioned. However, I think anybody strolling along here who's interested in a $17,500 boat will be attracted by the stunt. Especially if I ring the ship's bell a few times like this. Nine bells and all's well. You see, Julie, the whole purpose of advertising is to attract attention. Even ringing... Boy, Skipper. Mr. Thackeray.
Morning, Mr. Thackeray.
Good morning, Julie. Robert, may I inquire why the Thackeray Realty Company has put out to sea this morning?
Well, Mr. Thackeray, we really do want to get rid of that cabin cruiser.
Yes, ever since I put out these deck chairs, you see, three or four people have stopped by. Of course, most of them just wanted to buy deck chairs.
Mr. Thackeray, why don't you give Bob's idea a chance? It's very clever, and it really might work.
Well, if you think so. All right, we'll try it for one day.
Well, thank you, sir. One day's all I'll need.
Julie, will you please get my briefcase? I have an appointment in 10 minutes. Thank you, Julie. Good luck, Beanblossom. If you sell this boat in the next couple of hours, I'll put in a reorder for you.
Thank you, Mr. Thackeray.
We interrupt this musical program for a late news flash regarding the Lacey manhunt. The search for Lacey is concentrated in Southern California, where he and Reiner, his right-hand man, are believed to be in hiding.
Hey, boss, how come they never mentioned me in them broadcasts?
The FBI feels certain the men will attempt to get out of the country as quickly as possible.
Turn it off.
In the meantime...
You said the boat's in good shape?
Mr. Lacey, if we can pick up the Seahawk, we hit the jackpot. Going over from one end to the other, it's right.
Better be. It's got to take us all the way to South America.
Want me to find out if the FBI's tipped him off?
Yeah. And if he doesn't know anything...
I'll flash you the word. See you in a minute, friend?
Oh, yes, sir. There's something I can do for you?
Maybe. While driving by, I noticed your little display here. Mind telling me a little about it?
Why, certainly. What would you like to know?
Well, are you handling the sale personally, or do we have to deal with a regular ship's broker?
Oh, Thackeray Realty Company handles all of its own ships personally, yes.
Oh, you're the only person we have to do business with?
That eliminates the middleman.
That's a splendid idea. I'd like to hear more about this little craft.
It's a pleasure. Now, if you'll notice here, these are the interior shots that were made. This is all Philippine mahogany here. Now, all of this in here, too. As you can see, the boat's practically brand new. It's only been used on Sundays. It was owned by a wealthy Pasadena family. They took very good care of it.
Does it have a ship-to-shore radio?
Oh, yes, the very late... I'm terribly sorry. We only have one boat, and this gentleman was first.
That's okay. He's with me.
Oh, good. There's nothing I hate more than not having enough to go around. Won't you gentlemen step in the office, please? I'll show you the specifications. Miss Marshall, these two gentlemen are interested in our cabin cruiser. Do you have the plans?
Oh, yes, sir.
Thank you. Step this way, please. We're moving Willis. He hasn't done so well lately. Well, I'd like to go over the specifications with you, if I may. The decks, the engines, the special portholes, the anchors, and so forth. Now, here we have...
Fine, fine. I think this is just the boat we're looking for. When can we sign the papers?
Well, all I have to do is to give you the ignition keys and the two life preservers outside, and you're ready to shove off. Of course, if the price seems a bit high...
Oh, the price is fine. You've made yourself a deal, sir.
Well, thank you. Miss Marshall, you can take the cabin cruiser off the market.
Why, Bob, Mr. Beanblossom. Yes, sir.
I'll get the papers on the port in the safe. Incidentally, gentlemen, I should have warned you. I'm an excellent judge of character. I had you pegged from the moment I saw you.
What do you mean?
Well, for one thing, I think I can tell you exactly what line of business you're in. Ah, I've intrigued you, haven't I?
Well, let's just say that we'd like to know what you know.
Okay. You're, scientists.
Scientists? Oh, yeah, sure.
You're absolutely right. Allow me to introduce ourselves. This is my friend, Professor Edwards.
How do you do, Professor?
And I'm Professor Harper.
Oh, yes, how do you do? I'm Beanblossom.
We're planning a secret scientific expedition to the west coast of South America.
A secret expedition? Oh, really? Tell me, whom are you trying to keep it a secret from?
Another expedition. You see, they're anxious to get to the site of our archaeological discoveries before we do.
Ah, yes, I understand. Well, your secret is safe with me. One moment. Miss Marshall, don't allow anyone to interrupt us. We're discussing a secret expedition to South America. It's safe with her, too.
So, you see, Mr. Beanblossom, time is most important. We must get delivery of the Seahawk at once in order to get to the old ruin that we intend to excavate.
Yes, and that old ruin isn't getting any younger.
Ah, yes, I understand, gentlemen. Anything for the cause of science. Well, Professor, if you'll just sign right here, the Seahawk is yours. Just on the upper line, please.
Yep.
Thank you.
There you are, sir. Now, about the financial arrangements.
Oh, yes, I've often heard that you gentlemen of science are frequently short of cash. I think I can arrange a loan for you with the bank.
The foundation that sponsors our expedition has authorized me to pay cash for the boat.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yes, well, a check will be perfectly satisfactory.
I said cash, Mr. Beanblossom.
Of course, the down payment in cash.
All cash.
All cash?
Ah, you've got it. The foundation always pays cash.
Yes, this is a secret expedition, and you can't trace cash.
But I've never heard I've never seen it. Excuse me. Miss Marshall, would you step in here, please? I'd like to have you see $17,500 in cold cash.
Closing up, Bob.
Come in, Julie. Have a cigarette?
Mm-hmm, thanks.
You know, Julie, sooner or later, every man finds his place in life. I was never meant to sell lots or houses. I found my place. I'm a super boat salesman. Oh, yeah.
Well, you certainly sold Professor Harper and friend.
Putty in my hands. I practically had them hypnotized with my salesmanship, taking all this beautiful money from them, like taking candy from a baby.
Well, maybe you'd better put that candy in the safe.
No, Julie, I think I have to count it again. Never seems to come out right. You know, there are two things that I love the smell of. Fresh bread and fresh money. Wouldn't it be awful if I discovered I was allergic to money? Julie, would you consider going out with a successful boat salesman tonight? I don't think Mr. Thackeray'd mind if I helped myself to the commission.
I'm receptive, Mr. Beanblossom. What type of evening did you have in mind?
Miss Marshall, this'll be an evening you'll never forget. Dinner at Romanoff's, dancing a mocambo, a moonlight dip at Malibu, bullfights at Tijuana. I'll cover you with gardenias at Acapulco. Gay, carefree Mexico. Hasta la vista.
I'm awfully sorry. They gave me the wrong number. Possibly the wrong country.
Oh, hello, Miss Thackeray.
Beanblossom. I might have guessed. Bobo, it might interest you to know, my boy, that I have sold one of the lots in the Thornton estate. I have a check for $3,500 right here in my pocket.
Oh, you sold one of the lots, Mr. Thackeray? Why only one?
Well, matter of fact, I had a good prospect for the other two, but you see, I've had a little trouble with my... Hey, wait a minute. Why am I making excuses to you? What have you done today?
Well,
As a matter of fact, what are you doing right now?
Julie and I are sitting on the floor in your office.
Put Julie on.
Yes, Mr. Thackeray?
Julie, what are you and Bob doing?
Sitting on the floor in your office.
Put Bob back on.
Yes, Mr. Thackeray.
All right, Bob, you win. Just tell me the rest of it in your own words.
Well, there's money scattered all over your office.
Oh, well, that's normal. I suppose the floor is littered with it.
No, Julie and I are picking it up off the floor. That's why we're down there.
Only I could think of some way to get my dime back from this phone call.
Mr. Thackeray, I think I should mention this to you. I sold the boat today.
You sold? Put Julie on.
It's true, Mr. Thackeray. Bob did sell the boat.
Put Bob back.
Yes, Mr. Thackeray?
You sold the boat?
Yeah, he says, for $17,500. Hello? Hello, Mr. Thackeray?
You sound upset, sir.
Upset? Don't be silly! I'm calm as a cucumber!
No use, Bob. It still comes out $5 too much.
Yes, this is the ninth time. Well, there's no doubt about it, Julie. They've overpaid us.
I'm afraid they have. Oh, well, don't worry about it. We can just drop this in the mail to them.
Oh, that's just it. I can't. They're sailing tonight, and they didn't leave me a forwarding address. No, Julie, we're going to have to get out to the harbor at San Pedro.
Oh, Bob, it's only $5.
Julie, it's not a question of $5. It's the principle of the thing. These men are scientists. They sacrifice for humanity.
And what about our date, Mr. Beanblossom?
Oh, don't you worry. We'll have a nice romantic dinner in one of those little beach restaurants. I promised you. This will be an evening you'll never forget. Isn't this romantic?
Bob, you're talking to a piling.
Oh, yeah. Give me a hand. Oh, thanks.
It's getting pretty foggy, Chief.
We want it so thick those boys on the Coast Guard boat won't be able to see each other. Another hour and we miss the harbor patrol.
Don't fall. Ahoy, professors! Here you are. Well, we were afraid we'd missed you.
How very nice, Mr. Beanblossom.
Thank you.
You remember my friend, Professor Edwards?
Oh, yes. Mm-hmm.
And Professor Hennessy.
Hi.
It's a pleasure. Miss Marshall, gentlemen.
How do you do? I trust there's nothing wrong.
Well, I'm afraid there is, Professor. After you left our office, we made a little discovery.
What kind of a discovery?
Well, you see, when Mr. Beanblossom counted the money, he found that you'd overpaid him $5.
So you see, there was only one thing left to do. Here's your money, Professor.
Well, Mr. Beanblossom, I think that as a reward for your honesty, you should keep that $5.
Oh, no, I couldn't do that.
We insist.
Well, of course, if you insist. Look, as long as I'm here, I think the least I can do is explain to you some of the excellent features of this boat. Now, right here, we have a two-way radio which transmits as well as receives.
Yes, we know about that, thank you.
And you know, just behind this door is a couch that opens into a double bed. Excuse me just a second.
We know about that, too.
Yes. Funny, seems to be stuck.
Don't worry about it. There'll be plenty of time to fix it during the trip.
I understand this.
Bob, I think we should be going.
Yes, I'm coming, Julie. If you just hit it at the top a couple of times, like this, it'll, Well, it's been awfully nice knowing you, gentlemen, and bon voyage.
happen to meet unfriendly, natives?
Excuse me. Oh, officer. Maybe you can tell me. Has the Seahawk left yet?
No, sir. Straight ahead at the foot of the landing.
Well, thank heaven. I'd hate to have driven 25 miles through this fog and then missed it. One of my salesmen made a terrible mistake, you see. Oh, well. Never mind. Thank you very much, officer.
Get out of sight, but keep him covered. Take her with you.
Wait a minute. Who are you?
Remember, you're my guest. Someone?
Why, yes, I want... Oh, hello, Bob.
Well, if it isn't Mr. Willis P. Jones of the FBI.
Beanblossom,
that's
what...
That's right, Robert S. Beanblossom, undercover man. And all the time you thought I was a real estate salesman. Really crossed you up, didn't I?
Bob, what are you...
We have them surrounded, haven't we, Chief? I suppose you brought plenty of tear gas, hand grenades, handcuffs, and patrol wagons. So, he hasn't a chance, has he, Mr. Jones?
You'll have to excuse my salesman. He has a very peculiar sense of humor.
You his boss?
Willis P. Thackeray. Thackeray Realty Company. Here's my card.
Funny, I could have sworn he was Mr. Jones.
I came down to straighten out the bill of sale on the Seahawk.
Now, just a moment. If there's going to be any trouble...
Oh, no trouble, sir. You see, Beanblossom here made out the sale on the standard dwelling form. So if you just sign these, then the boat will be legally yours.
Well, that's all there is to it.
That's all right there on the bottom. Beanblossom, if you'd stop reading that cops and robbers stuff and pay more attention to business, you wouldn't get me into these messes. Well, thank you. Come on.
If you don't mind, I've persuaded Mr. Beanblossom to demonstrate the boat on a trial run.
In this fog? No, I don't mind at all. Goodbye, Beanblossom.
Bye, Miss Thackeray.
Undercover man. Why, I ought to...
Pardon me. I seem to have forgotten my briefcase. Machine guns.
Won't you join the party, Mr. Jones?
So here we are, where you came in. Bound hand and foot, and waiting for the harbor patrol to pass so Professor Harper and his friends could take us out to sea and dump us. But they weren't counting on shrewd, resourceful Beanblossom.
How long, Mr. Lacey?
This waiting around makes me nervous.
Just a few minutes, Tom. Turn on the radio, see if we can get the weather report.
Gee, I never seen so many dials.
No, no, that's the transmitter.
Oh, sorry, boss. There, I got it.
With fog becoming heavier along the coast later this evening, tomorrow will be clear. This is the U.S. Coast Guard signing off.
Coast Guard? Gosh, if they only knew we were here. I say, if they only knew we were here.
What can we do about that surplus cargo?
Maybe I ought to take care of them now.
Relax, relax. There's plenty of time to take care of them after we pass the 12-mile limit. My deal.
I got an idea.
Given me nothing but trouble.
Speaking of trouble, you remember that bank job in Philly? We had to chop down two guards, and for all our troubles, we only got a measly 10 grand. Pass.
Three.
There. Just wait till the Coast Guard gets a load of this. Okay, fellas, start talking.
Pass. I'm broke.
Broke? What do you do with all your money?
Well, I have to help my poor old mother out, don't I? She's getting too old to work anymore.
It's a very admirable trait. I try to make a sizable contribution to my relatives, too.
They've changed the subject.
My brother and his wife got quite a family. Two sets of twins.
Yeah. I love twins.
What a
set of each.
Gee.
The littlest one's really something. I wonder if she still got those teddy bears I gave her.
I love teddy bears, too.
Darn it, the wire slipped.
Speaking of my brother, he's supposed to meet us in Rio with the syndicate money.
Yeah, but suppose he gets picked up by the FBI, Mr. Leahy.
We're the ones who have to worry about the FBI. Three cards.
I think I've got it. The transmitter wire runs from this point over the condenser, down through the amplifier, and across the grid. Yeah, that's right. If I can just pull this wire a little more, get it over where I can short it. Now. There. I made it.
The radio.
Get him in here. They're asking for it ahead of time.
Think they got word to the Coast Guard?
I don't know, but we're not going to stick around to find out.
Let's go. Let's go.
Get the engine started.
Yes.
The chains.
Now?
We can't take any more chances. The water's plenty deep here.
Right.
I'm sorry, Julie. Mr. Thackeray, please forgive me. It was all my fault. I said it's my fault.
Rainer!
I'm sorry, Mr. Lacey.
The Lacey gang.
All right, get over there. Well, this is something. All right, move over. I'll have you out in a jiffy, folks.
Officer, are we glad to see you. We didn't even think our radio message got through.
Radio message? I came down here to see who belongs to that midget job up there in the wharf. Then I bumped into this character with a machine gun. I'm glad he had his back turned.
Did you say midget job?
That's right. There's a sign up there big as a house. Says no vehicles allowed. But there's always some bird brain that can't read.
Maybe I should fly south for the winter.
Bobo, my boy, you just saved our lives.
Congratulations.
All right, come on.
Just one instant, Julie. Excuse me, Julie. Mr. Lacey, here's your $5.
My hero.
You see, folks, honesty is the best policy.